Hey YouTube, this is Widowmaker. I'm gonna try something different today. I got a little bit of Ford dark blue. I'm gonna mix it with some lime green. And we're gonna see what that comes out, how good that comes out. Got me some bullets right here. I noticed that the bullets are a little rusty. I had some 40 bullets or 45 that were older, and they turned out to be like zombie green. They're marbled a little bit, but my wife liked them. She's like, them are about the best bullets, turned out the best that you've made. And I'm like, well, I prefer them to be more like these. Yeah, but that's what I got. Bullets were a little oxidized, I guess. Lead does rust if you leave it out. The elements when we're in this building, yeah. I made these a while back. Again, you can tell how oxidized that they are in them. This is like Civil War bullets, some of them do. The lead's oxidized, rusted. Alright, so we're just gonna try something a little different just to be doing it. So try this. It's already like 80 some degrees out here. It's about 10 o'clock. It is 10:37 and it's about 85 already. As soon as winter's over, we start complaining about the heat. All right, let's see. Turn that fan around. Wow. Starting to sweat. I don't like sweating. Okay. Just looks like blue and green. Okay. Might make it for a neat effect. We'll try it and see. We get one. And shake them off. Intelligent me.
Hold on just a second. Intelligent me preheating my oven. Didn't take the
bagpipe basket out. So that's intelligent. Kind of got curry there. Preheat that oven. Take that out. Alright, I'll be back in just a minute. I gotta cool this off a bit. Alright, YouTube, and we're back. Let's see what we got. It's time to see what we got. So, let's see. Kind of a unique color. Orange, do a little bit more. Maybe I need to mix the powder up a bit more. I'm just experimenting. I'd say that I might need to add more green to that. Yeah, she's a different shade now. I don't know if you can see that. Definitely a different shade now. It's almost, it's a greenish tan color, I think, down there. Something like that. I'm gonna have that one so long. So, anyway, let's flip these over and knock them out. Powder count in the 45s because it was getting too tedious, believe it or not, to do it the traditional way. I wish that I would have gotten into this a little bit sooner. I wouldn't have bought a lubricizer. But at the time I bought the lubricizer, I don't think that this was the information was not out at the time. So I think at the time what was out was people were using, they weren't using powder coat, they were using paint. I can't remember the exact kind of paint, you can look it up. And they were just tumbling with paint. Not powder coat, it was just paint. That's how they're going at that time. It didn't look very promising, not like how it was. But I never experimented with it, so. But I just got tired of going up the good traditional way. And this way is a lot faster. Yeah, you still got to size your pullets, but and you have to do it the traditional way too. Of course, it sizes the lube at the same time. But I use the lead sizer for these. And I'm going to let these cool, and I'm going to just size some. Show you what that's like, which I'm sure you already know what it's like, but I'll size some, let y'all check that out. So, we'll be back here in just a second. Alright guys, we're all set up to start sizing these bad boys. Right here is what how they turned out. So, different. Something different. It's kind of an art of its own, so you can mess around with them. So we got our sizing die set up. We're sizing these a 4.52, and that's all you do is just put them on there and press up on it. This is a lot faster than lubricizing, so. Really, you wouldn't have to put lube on it, you just size it, but I just decided that a lot simpler, these sizing dies are a lot simpler, and for these sizing dies to be an alternative for the lubricizer,
seems to be the best method to size your cast bullets with are these Lee sizers, and they're inexpensive. I think I paid $23 for that one, and I got it on eBay, so $23 for it. Now, they did hold the A-locks out of it. It was just a sizing die only with no A-locks, but I don't care because I'm not using A-locks, so. But I got a bottle of it. Man, I got the drops. I got a bottle of it in there. I was going to use it for, you can mix it like 50-50 NRA recipe for your lube, 50% beeswax, 50% A-locks, but I was going to use some beeswax because it is pretty expensive. I was just going to substitute the beeswax with paraffin. I don't think there's been a whole lot of difference there. Beeswax may have a little bit more lubricity to it. I don't know. Paraffin's got it would have some to it since it's a little based, petroleum based. But I haven't used beeswax, to be honest with you, because like I said, it is kind of pricey. I did find a place at one time as a candle making place that was about the most reasonable site that I found, but I just used paraffin for all that. And I made all my wax. Matter of fact, they had a big cake of paraffin wax over there that had been melted. It's out of the cake, original cake shape that it was in, because it has melted so many different times. And I was going to fire up the old Coleman stove and heat that up and pour it in something, put it away so it don't get dirt and stuff, debris in it. But I never did that. Anyway, guys, that's your sizing 45 cast bullet, powder coated cast bullets. So as you can see, it's as fast as pushing up, down, setting the next one. I mean, it's that fast. A lot faster than what I was doing with my lubricizer. And the beauty of it is it's a lot cheaper. So I might end up pocketing my lubricizer on eBay or something. That lubricizer was pretty thin. Is there $200? I'm thinking it's right. It might have been $180. Something like that. It's a lineman. 4,500, I believe, if I'm not right, if I'm not mistaken. And then I did all these the other day. My zombie rounds. And these are all sized and ready to go. And then, of course, I got some loaded, as I showed you earlier. These are ready to take some zombies out. So anyway, guys, it's just, this is an art to this, and there's really nothing chiseled in stone. It's just experimentation, and hopefully y'all will share your experiences if you found something new. If I find out anything new from anybody, I'll be sure to give the credit that's due and put it on my video. So I got some more bullets out there. They're being heated up. Man, I can't believe how hot it is. Last week it was cold and crap, and this week it's hotter than Hades. Anyway, I got some more bullets out there that are in the oven. We'll check them out and see how they turn out. They're going to be more greenish, I believe, than what these here are, more bluish. But that's fine. Like I said, it's all experimentation. There is really no right or wrong way as far as color and all that. And if anybody finds out neater and newer and easier techniques, please share. And we'll check out the time that's out there left on the bullets. And then we shall check them out. So we'll be back in just a sec. Alright, YouTube, and we're back. Let's check these things out, shall we? Let's see how good of it. The wind's picking up now. It's banging into the camera. The door is. Let me get it. Looks like the ones that we just did, ain't they? But they're more greener. But that's cool. Guys, I'm using Eastwood powders. They're a little bit more expensive than Harbor Freight. You get a half a pound for about $10. And they can run specials. I got this here, half a pound for $8 and something. So yeah, it's 8 ounces. But it's good powder, and you don't have to worry about tumbling. Tumbling in a traditional vibratory tumbler, you just tumble like you do your Aelox bullets. You want to Aelox them, and that's it. As easy as that. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you're not already, and have a good one. Like, share, and subscribe. Later. Widow out.